We're in CCDC, Clark County Detention Center in Las Vegas. I don't believe that pimping and hoeing is a criminal act. I think that it's immoral before God. If you get in a situation, and at that time, if you come to jail for something that you did, you can't cry then. You know what I'm saying? And if they thought that them bringing me to jail was supposed to strip me of me being the man that I am, but they badly mistaken. I'm gonna say that. They stripped me of everything. I was allowed to be stripped. But if what's really important to you is the things that you live your life for, you know, the man you're being, the character, and if you're willing to take the consequences that go along with whatever life you choose, then I think at the end, if you still have that, then you haven't lost anything at all.
The streets knew him as Gorgeous Dre in the Hughes Brothers film American Pimp. Federal prison knew him as number 33599-048. Now Andre Taylor rises.
It's time for a tonight party! Starring me, Ed the Sock, and my buddy, Greg Campbell!
Tonight, firm American pimp and master of the game, Gorgeous Dre!
Okay, so here I am in L.A., where numerous celebrity types have whored themselves out making movies. Where better for me to begin my education into the high-stakes world of Hollywood pimping than here? And who better to teach me than Gorgeous Dre, the star of the famous Hughes Brothers documentary, American Pimp, and the producer of his own film on pimping, Master of the Game.
Yeah.
Hey, Dre.
Let's go, man.
Go. Where are we going?
Hey, man, we're going to go on Sunset Boulevard.
Right.
You know, the place where the hoes roam or have. They kind of shut it down now, but I want to give you a little history on that famous hoe stroll. Well, Ed, this is Sunset Boulevard. This
All
is,
right.
like, the most popular
right.
hoe stroll in the whole country at
Hoe stroll.
This is a hoe
stroll. Hoe stroll. Okay, I'm learning the lingo.
Thing.
All right.
And there was a time that girls would be lined up, 50 to 100 girls, lined up on this street right here.
Let's just say I want to be a pimp, Dre. What do I need to do? Take me through the steps.
Well, first of all, Ed, we're going to have to do something with your threads.
My threads? So, you know, Ashley, I think we got a real good chemistry here, you and I, and I'm, you know, hoping to start up my own little stable, and I need a very important young lady, and I think that you and I, we got a good chemistry going on, and
yeah.
I was thinking, what, huh?
Are you trying to dirty mag me or something?
What? Hey, no, we're
you
just talking.
To dirty mag me?
We're just talking.
I didn't teach you that, Ed.
No, I picked
you
it up
learned
the
that
movie.
From, you learned that from somewhere else.
Hey, it's a dog-eat-dog world, okay, pal?
I'm going to give you some good game.
Okay.
I'm going to give you some real good game. The whole concept of this is so many people think that the pimp was the one that was the architect of the lifestyle. But before there was any pimp, there was hoes. Pimps didn't create the hoes. Hoes created the pimps. And that's what most people don't understand. And if every pimp in the world is gone and dead, there's going to still be some hoes hoeing. God game.
Heavy duty, man. My guess, Andre Taylor, a.k.a. Mr. Gorgeous Dre, man. How you doing, player? What's going on
I
with you,
I feel wonderful, man. How you feeling?
Man, I'm feeling wonderful, too, also, man.
Yeah.
I got a question, man. The last time everybody seen you, man, you know what I'm saying, you was facing life in the pen.
Yeah, yeah.
How long you been on the turf now, man?
Well, you know, I got out of prison August 9th. Well, actually, May 23rd, but I went to the halfway house. So I got out of halfway house August 9th in 2001. And since I've been out, you know, I've been kind of, you know, been on the low, you know, and trying to create some products and things, you know what I'm saying? But just been trying to stay out the way because I had 3 years of probation, you know? And, you know, it was so easy to get violated. So the best thing to do when you get out and you're on paper just to kind of lay low. I've pretty much come full circle. Let me tell you a story. I jog. You know, every day. And one day I saw a 9-year-old little girl and about a 7-year-old little boy. And they noticed me, they recognized me. Because they said, oh, you know, there goes that pimp.
Wow.
And that was a devastating thing to me. You know, at that moment, that felt like the worst thing that ever happened to me. For them kids at 9 and 7 to look at me with glossy eyes.
Man.
As if being a pimp was the thing to be.
Mm-hmm.
So Master of the Game is to bring that child and the rest of the people to the inner sanction of this life. Because when an individual really sees the totality of my film, they going to know this is really not nothing I want to be in. Not because it's so bad, but because it requires far more than the average person thinks. I'm not looking down on nobody that chose a lifestyle because I come from that. My mama come from that. My daddy come from that. But the story don't stop there.
Let's give him some more. Master the game. Check it out.
An American pimp, he warned us about his women.
The most money that I've ever made in one night was 22 grand.
His words empowered us.
This is something that will destroy him.
King Magazine hails him the West Coast Don, the most anticipated follow-up to the movie American Pimp.
Like I'm suited and booted because I'm with Gorgeous Dre.
Gorgeous Dre brings you Master of the Game.
What I'm about to give you now is priceless.